That was number one from the workbook, page 27. Let's go over number two there. Number two says I want to find the solutions for the equation 8x squared minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay. And you could have done that by any of the methods you wanted to. Notice number two, all the answers, none of the answers have imaginary numbers or square roots. So it is factorable. You can always check. If you look at all the answer choices on page 27 for number two, that means if there isn't any i's or if there's no square roots, then the problem is factorable. So we could try to factor this out. Okay, so that's what we'll do here. So 8 times negative 3 that would give me negative 24. And I want to see what multiplies to negative 24. And adds up to our middle number there, negative 2. And those two will go in my parentheses. So add it to negative 2 and multiply to negative 24, and those would be 6 and 4. So I put those in there. And I got to figure out where the negative sign should go. It should go on the 6. In order to make a negative 2, negative 6 plus 4 would be negative 2. Those are my numbers that go inside my parentheses here, negative 6 and 4. So I get x minus 6 and x plus 4. Now I'm not done. I initially multiply by this 8 to get those negative 24. I got to divide out by that 8. Whenever you have a leading coefficient that's not 1, in this case it was 8, I have to go ahead and divide that 8 on both of these. Divide 8, divide by 8. Okay, that's the only added step when you have that right there. You have a leading coefficient, so I go ahead and work that out, and I get x minus. This simplifies to, let's see, can both divide these by 2, so I'll get 3 over 4. And here, this is 1 half, so I get x plus 1 half. Now, if I wanted to write in factored form, I'd bring those, that 4 up in front of the x and the 2 in front of the x and have it fully factored. But here, I'm just solving the equation that equals 0, so I want to just separate in the two parts. How do I make this equal to 0? Well, I have x equals 3 over 4. 3 over 4 minus 3 over 4 would equal 0. And my other answer there would be negative 1 half. Negative 1 half plus 1 half would be 0 as well. So those are my two answers there. If you look at number three's answer choices, again, on page 27, look at those answer choices, and you'll notice that C and D both have square roots. Okay, so that problem is not factorable. When you have square roots like that, you got to solve by completing the square or using the quadratic formula, one of those two. Okay. So keep that in mind for numbers 3 and 4. But they're pretty much the same. You can just use quadratic formula instead. I went over that in detail yesterday. Let's skip to number 5 here. Number 5 says the area of a rectangle is 70 square meters. The length is 4 meters less than twice the width. What is the length? Okay. So let's bring up number 5 here and let's go over that one. So I have an area of a rectangle, and our area formula for a rectangle is just kind of what we went over yesterday in another problem. It was just the length times the width, and I want to fill those in step by step using this right here. So the area of a rectangle is 70 square meters. So we go ahead and fill that in for area, it would be 70. The length over here, the length is 4 meters less than twice the width. When you have that less than, make sure you put that at the end. We got to subtract that from something. So 4 meters less than twice the width would be 2 times the width. So that is what I'm going to substitute for the length. The length is 2w minus 4. So I got to go ahead and do that right here. Instead of the length, I'm going to put 2w minus 4 times the width. And now I have a nice simple equation with only one variable that I can solve. So I get 70 is equal to, here you go ahead and distribute. W times 2w, I get 2w squared. W times negative 4, I get negative 4w. Now, all these numbers can be divided by 2, so we can always just divide the whole equation to make it the numbers a little smaller to work with. And I get 35 is equal to w squared minus 2w. Now, it's not wrong if you don't divide by 2, it's just the numbers are a little easier to work with if you do. And then lastly, I want to set it equal to 0, or I could use completing the square, but usually quadratic formula is a little bit easier. So go ahead and subtract 35 from both sides. And I end up with 0 is equal to w squared minus 2w minus 35. And we can go ahead and use quadratic formula or factor this. Let's try factoring first because that's usually a little bit easier. Negative 35, and I want to multiply negative 35 and add up to negative 2. And 7 and 5 make 35, and negative 7 would make that negative 2 that I need. So I need negative 7 and positive 5 as my numbers in there. I get w minus 5 and w plus 5. Solving that out, I would get w equals 7 and w equals negative 5. Okay. Now, this is supposed to be the width of a rectangle, so I got to eliminate the negative value, and that's depending on the word problem there. So I can only use this as my width. Okay. Then I relook at the problem, and it says there that what is the length? Now I just found the width. The width was 7. I need to find the length though, and I have my nice formula for the length right here, which I'm just going to plug into. So I go ahead and plug that in there. The length is equal to 2 times the width, which you just found is 7, minus 4. And I get length is 14 minus 4, or the length is 10. Okay. And then we're talking about meters, so it would be 10 meters. Okay, so be careful there. They did have a 7 as one of the answer choices, but that would be marked wrong. They asked for the length, not the width, so you need to put 10 there. And you can verify pretty easily that that makes sense. 10 times 7 is 70. And this formula verifies the other part, that if you double it, you get 14, and minus 4, you get our length there, 10. update. Moving on to the next one there, number six. Okay, number six says the base of a triangle is 4 meters more than 3 times the height, and there is 66 centimeters. And Austin wrote the equation. So they already give you the equation, okay, where h represents the height of the triangle. Okay. He then entered in some graphing calculator and looked at the table below, so he got all the information. Okay. What is the height of the triangle? So we want the peak of the triangle, and we're saying that is h. Well, usually we have, instead of h there, the x. So the height is going to be x. Okay. Here in this formula, if you look at these two, h is being replaced by x, because the graphing calculator only uses x and y. So these would be our heights. And we usually solve that for when it equals 0. So when y equals 0, like if I get 3 over 2x squared plus 2x minus 66 equals 0, I get my height of 6. And that's going to be our height there, 6. If you look at the previous problem, we did that as well. We solved it for equal to 0, worked that out. Same thing here, but they do all the work for you in the table. You just got to identify where it's a 0 on the y there, and we get 6. And that's all you have to do there. And get 6 centimeters, so it'll just be B there. Because of this table value there. Okay. If you look at number seven is not too bad. It's just 2x squared equals 36, and we can solve that fairly easily. You have to divide by 2 first. If you take the square root, it's a little more difficult. And I get x squared is equal to 18. Then I take the square root of both sides, and I get x is equal to plus or minus square root of 18. Make sure to add that plus or minus part in there. And I go to work that out. And 18, I would have to go ahead and do the little factor tree on the side. I'm looking for pairs. And it's 2 and 9, and 9 is has 3 and 3. So from that pair, I get to bring out a 3, and I get x equals plus or minus 3 square root of 2. Number 8, you should have just subtracted 21 and then factor that out. Number 9 just asks you to write the factors down. So that shouldn't have been too much trouble there. Number 10, they want you to figure that one as well out. Again, looking at the answer choices, let's look at the answer choices on number 9 and 10, and that'll kind of give you a way that 9 you just need to factor. They list them all, add up to negative 13 and multiply to 36. So just check them all here. 6 times negative 6, that does add up, multiply to 36, but not positive 36, so that wouldn't work. Negative 15 and 2, that just makes negative 30. It doesn't work. Negative 12 and negative 3, that does make positive 36, but if you add those two, you get negative 15, so that doesn't work. So it must be this last one. negative 9 and negative 4, add up to negative 13, and multiply to positive 36. It'd be D there. Number 10, they ask you to only find the positive solution. So, and they list whole numbers there, so you could try to use quadratic formula on that, or factor if possible. You just need to subtract 28 from both sides first. The last one there, number 11, find all the solutions to this one here. Okay. This problem does have imaginary as the possible answers. So you want to use quadratic formula. You might not be able to factor this one. Okay, so just you can add 49, or you can take the square root of both sides, writing this not individually though, actually it's better to add 49 and work that out. Okay. And so make sure to finish that assignment up on your own if you haven't already. All right, next, if you go ahead and turn to page 14 in the workbook. On page 14, you'll see that we're going over complex numbers again. So since we're kind of using those in our quadratic formula sometimes, those are one where we have the imaginary and real parts. And our imaginary is we put on the y-axis here. And our real, we put on the what used to be our x-axis. And then we go ahead and graph them. For example, if I want to graph 3 minus 2i, I go along 3 on the real axis, 1, 2, 3, and down 2. And that would be my point A right there. Okay, so for classwork today, on your own paper, I want you to work on you have a little time to finish up the work if you didn't get to finish that yesterday, or start on the new one on page 14. You're going to go ahead and copy example one. The graph, and then you have to complete 1 through 6, on page 15, and write down the graphs. You must copy the graphs. Okay, so not too much work, just in case you didn't get to finish the work from yesterday as well. So working on really both of those if you didn't finish. If you did finish the work from yesterday, get started on this side assignment right here. Okay, on the top of this one, you can put number 31 for page 14. Again, if you have questions, make sure to bring them up to my desk, or if you want to just check the answers, I'm back here as well.